Good morning, students. So in last lecture, just we had completed about the capacitor, and this is a very small topic which is remaining in this chapter, and which is known as dielectric and polarization. So in capacitor also we are using the word dielectric. But what is dielectric? Dielectric means a substance which possesses equal number of positive and negative charges, which does not allow the electric current to pass through it, or the insulating materials are known as dielectric. The insulating material is known as dielectric, okay? And basically there are two types of the dielectric. One is polar, another one is non-polar. What is polar dielectric? Those dielectric which possess permanent electric dipole moment. You already know what is dipole moment: charge multiplied by distance between the two charges. So polar dielectric possess permanent electric dipole moment. Example, HCl, water, CO, etc. जिसमें center of gravity of the negative and positive charges are separated from each other. Minus and plus are separated from each other, so that one side we have the group of negative charge, other side we have the group of positive charge. Positive and negative separated from each other. And in non-polar, what happen? They does not possess permanent electric dipole moment, or the center of negative and positive charges are coincides with each other. They are uniformly distributed. Okay, example H2N2O2CO2, like that. Okay, so that is polar and non-polar dielectrics. And what is dielectric? The insulating materials are known as dielectric. Dielectric does not allow the electric current to pass through it. Remember this. But what is polarization? So when you take a non-polar, when a non-polar dielectric is placed in a uniform electric field between the two plates of the capacitor. Okay, electric field is from positive plate to the negative plate. As soon as you take this non-polar dielectric in uniform, the force is acting on the negative and positive charges, due to which negative and positive get separated from each other. Towards the positive plate we are having negative charge, and towards the negative plate we have the positive charge. Then dipole is induced, and this is known as, and this phenomenon is known as polarization. What is polarization? When a non-polar dielectric is placed in uniform electric field and center of gravity of positive and negative charges separated from each other, they get separated, negative toward the positive plate and positive towards the negative plate, then the dipole is induced. Abhi tak isme dipole nahi tha beta, aisa hai tha zero coincide, aisa nahi tha. Fir baad mein iske andar kya induce hua? Dipole is get induced, and this phenomenon is known as polarization. And the induced dipole moment is directly proportional to the intensity of electric field. And to remove this proportionality, we have to put some constant. That is the alpha E naught. And this alpha is known as atomic or molecular polarizability. क्या बोलते बेटा अल्फा को? एटॉमिक एंड मॉलिक्यूलर पोलराइजेबिलिटी. तो व्हाट इज डाइलेक्ट्रिक? इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल्स आर नोन एज डाइलेक्ट्रिक. बेसिकली देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डाइलेक्ट्रिक, पोलर एंड नॉन पोलर. पोलर पोजेस परमानेंट इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल मोमेंट, नॉन पोलर पोजेस नो परमानेंट इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल मोमेंट. एग्जाम्पल HCl, H2O CO, H2N2O2CO2. सेंटर ऑफ नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर, सेंटर ऑफ नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव कोइंसाइड्स विद ईच अदर. When a non-polar dielectric is placed in uniform electric field, it gets polarized. Center of negative or positive, negative and positive separated from each other. Towards positive plate we have negative charge, towards negative plate we have positive charge. Separation of negative positive from each other is known as polarization. And for induced dipole moment, P is equal to alpha E naught, where alpha is known as atomic or molecular polarizability. Okay dear, so in the next topic just we want to obtain the very very important point, that is the relation between electric dielectric constant and susceptibility. And we have to prove the relation, that is dielectric constant, okay, chi is equal to 1 plus k, okay, and that relation that we have to develop, dielectric constant 1 plus chi. So this is one of the very very important relation that we have to develop. But before that, just we are taking some important points. we are taking the two parallel plates of the capacitor, and between the two parallel plates we are taking a polar dielectric slab. Okay, between the two plates of capacitor, and the distance between the two plates is d. Already we know that. So what is the direction of the electric field due to the free charge? Charges on the plates of capacitor are known as the free charges. Okay, so when you take a dielectric slab, then due to the electric field of the free charges, all the dipoles are get arranged in the direction of the electric field, and they get arranged in particular one direction. Okay, they experience the source, their thermal energy is balanced by the potential energy. We are not going in that part detail, but all the dipoles are get arranged in the direction of external electric field. Okay, so near the positive plate we are having the line of negative charge, and near the negative plate we are having the line of positive charge. And internal columns, first column nullify the effect of second, second column will nullify the effect of third, plus minus, plus minus. So inside this we don't have any net resultant electric field, because they will net charge here. Inside this dotted part there is no net charge, charge is zero. Okay, so electric field due to free charges is simple. Kitni electric field hogi beta? Sigma upon epsilon zero. But due to the rearrangement of the induced dipoles on the dielectric slab, uske karan jo electric field hogi, that is sigma p upon epsilon. This is due to the free charge and this is due to the induced charge. These two electric field, kyunki yahan pe iska plus hai aur yahan pe iska plus hai, so both the electric fields are in opposite direction. So reduced electric field in the slab is given by E is equal to E minus, you take it as E dash. E dash is equal to E minus EP. Okay, so E dash is equal to sigma upon epsilon 0 minus sigma p upon epsilon 0, where sigma and sigma p are the surface charge density of free and induced charges. Then we are having polarization density. It is represented by capital P. So what is polarization density? The total induced dipole moment per unit volume of a dielectric slab is known as induced or polarization density. And polarization density is P total divided by volume. And what is dipole moment? Charge multiplied by distance between the two charges. And distance between two charges is d. Okay, and total charge किसके बराबर होगा बेटा? यहाँ पे एक step और लिख देता हूँ. तो total induced charge QP multiplied by d is the dipole, and QP is equal to sigma P A d upon A into d. A d cancel. तो P is equal to sigma P, and its unit is coulomb per meter square. And experimentally it is found that the ratio of P to E dash remains constant. The ratio of P to E dash remains constant, and this constant is represented by epsilon 0 chi E. And this symbol, it is a Greek symbol, it is called chi, CHI. And this chi is known as electric susceptibility. What it is known as? Electric susceptibility. So therefore we can write P is equal to epsilon 0 chi E into E dash. Okay, but we have to obtain K is equal to 1 plus chi E. Continue. Okay, P is equal to epsilon 0 chi E. So now तो यस बेटा, तो रिजल्टेंट इलेक्ट्रिक रिड्यूस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कितना था बेटा अंदर? E dash is equal to E minus EP. तो E की वैल्यू सिग्मा अपॉन एप्सिलॉन 0 और E सिग्मा P अपॉन एप्सिलॉन 0. एंड व्हाट इज सिग्मा P दैट वी हैड ऑब्टेन्ड? P इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा P. तो व्हेन यू सब्स्टिट्यूट इट्स वैल्यू हियर, देन व्हाट हैपन? एप्सिलॉन 0 एप्सिलॉन 0 कट गया बेटा, तो अपने को कितना मिल गया? अगर E dash से डिवाइड कर दूं तो 1 इज इक्वल टू E upon E dash minus, ये epsilon 0 यहां से कट गया बेटा, तो क्या बचा? Only chi. And E upon E dash is known as K, that is dielectric constant. उसको dielectric constant बोलते हैं. तो 1 is equal to K minus chi E. So therefore K is equal to 1 plus chi E. So this is the relation between dielectric constant and susceptibility.